because you know the degree of happiness which he gets while doing it instead of simply sitting at home and work, you know, enjoying life with the money that his son abroad is sending. You know, soiling the hand is very important. It's not dignity of labor only. Now he is giving the prescription that you drink so much of this one, you speak for so long, and then he is claiming that he is sleeping at 10 o'clock and he is waking at 5 a.m. That I have very means he is emphatically saying, you people are lazy. You will wake at, he is actually staring at all of you who are watching the film and he is saying, 5 a.m. Pachamukta. Pachamukta. So you know why he is saying that? He knows the lazy habit. With due apologies to industrious and enterprising Gohans, I am making this statement. He knows that most of the Gohans, except the old generation, nobody wakes up at 5 o'clock unless you have a race with time to complete a seminar or assignment or prepare for IIC. Right? That will happen. So basically when he said 10 to 5, he is prescribing a routine for others who are not in that business. He is saying that this is my lifestyle. I am happy. Are you? That is what statement is meaning. Because you know, first of all, from your documentary, there will go a culture shock. I don't know, because we have not read anything newspaper about how Rajasthan jury or audience reflected or they deliberated. There is nothing on Jodhpur International Film Festival website which I scanned. There is nothing. There is no critique also. So now let us take a hypothetical, you know, scenario in mind. That is, suppose this documentary is goes to a place where drinking is not a culture. How they will take it? What, according to the team, is the perception that what type of culture shock it will be for a non-alcoholic type of state, or you know, many are there in India, like where there is no tradition, let's say Madhya Pradesh or some other places.
Yeah, I think certain stereotypes of alcohol is already come up, firstly. You know, like people say everyone will go out drinks. So something like that. So then they will definitely come up with something like that. But other than that, I think it's difficult to look at it from like I was saying, you know, understand that it's but there was
so the moment he is justifying, now many states have prohibition also. Mm-hmm. Gujarat has prohibition. So Jain of their documentary took out Thomas Murray. Thomas Santa took out 300 ml of Udra Geta. I mean, it is a bold statement for people who cannot even imagine. First of all, they do not get 300 ml clean drinking water to drink in many of the states. So in those states, 300 ml Soro Anga Geta to Adi Koro Patra Kaha Vasla Te. And these are every day 300 ml. Plus he is prescribing also how much?
30 ml
of training. So 900 ml of 1 liter per month. 12 liters per year. Okay, so you see that the message that we go to a non-drinking audience is, this is generally what he says is the culture of law, but that is not truly the case. So how you feel is, instead of importing that type of culture, so don't you think that the same, this one has to be balanced by actually putting
up
something?
But I think somewhere, you know, it works in like, you know, opposite psychology, because what I realized is like, if you see Iranian movies, you know, how they are so constrained and everything, they are so bound by, they cannot go against the law. But they work, you know, like, if you see them, how they work. Yeah, and how they work. How they work in say LA Film Festival or somewhere in USA, where this is completely against the thing. You know, where they are a democracy where you can make a film like Death of a President, where you make a fake assassination of George Bush and you kill him in the movie, and George Bush is the president. That kind of democracy they have. And there's an Iranian film that comes into that country and it still works. So I think in some ways it's also about opposite cycle, something you can't relate to. Because in a place which has prohibition also, there will be people who drink.
Right.
And there will be people who will look at it the other way and say, you know what, this is interesting, because we don't understand it, we don't see it around us. But obviously there will be people who will, you know, stereotype and say that, you know, Goa, you know, this is why people go to Goa, and they always get drunk, you know, that kind of thing. You can't stop those kind of extreme opinions. But
questions?